Hi there. So, in the last couple of years, I've learned some tricks you can do in Photoshop that will save you a ton of time. So, this video is about 7 things that allowed my workflow to be faster and more precise. Alright, so before we start, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button. Let's begin. The first one is masks. When dealing with architecture images, you gotta learn how to use them properly. Otherwise, it will work in a destructive way, and when you need to do some changes, there won't be any option. So, as an example, I'm going to apply a wooden texture in this area right here. Hit CTRL T and rotate it 90 degrees. I always like to go over a little when applying the texture so the mask will trim right exactly where I want it. For that, I'm gonna rasterize it and copy and paste within the same layer. That way, I have one layer with all the texture. And now I'm going to hit the mask button right down here. As you can see, the mask created a white fill, and what that means is everything is showing on the layer. We're gonna fill with black the parts that we don't want to show it. So, using the polygonal lasso tool and lowering the opacity of the layer, I can see exactly where I gotta select. It's a bit hard to see right here, but I think it's right there. I'm gonna select the part that I don't want to be in the image. With the selection done, we can hit Alt Backspace to fill black the area. As you can see, this is what we get when applying a mask, and then we can put the opacity to 100 again. See, you can use the mask in an inverted way. For that, I'm gonna apply another texture just to show you. Let's get this stone texture. The same procedure. I'm gonna scale it down, rasterize it, and then hit Ctrl A to duplicate within the same layer. And now, this time, I'm gonna hit the mask button, but holding Alt. And what that does is creating a black filled rectangle, meaning that everything is not showing. So I'm gonna make the same selection in the area, but this time I'm gonna select only the things that I want to show it and paint it white. Again, foreground color, holding Alt and hit Backspace. I know it doesn't look right in the image. It's missing the shadow and there are some missing pixels on the edge, but that's the good thing about masks. You can always come back later and fix any mistakes you've made. And hit Alt Backspace, and there you go. Then we can go for our next item from the list, the Ctrl Alt G shortcut. This shortcut you can use in various ways, and the most interesting one is, for example, we have a shadow right here that is not going to our new applied textures. What I like to do to work in a non-destructive way is create a new layer and then hit Ctrl Alt and G. What that does is link this layer to that one. For example, if you paint anything, it will only show on the layer underneath it, the layer linked to it. So, for example, I can paint everything, but only the areas in the stone texture will show. So that way I can hide just for a second and very roughly just mark the areas that are darker from the shadow, and then I can paint it. See, I You can just lower the opacity and there we go, it's done. You can also use this method to the adjustment layers right here. For example, I don't want this wood to be so yellow, so I can create a hue saturation adjustment and hit CTRL ALT G or click on this button, and everything that I do with this adjustment will only affect the linked layer. For instance, if I change the hue settings, I don't know, to a more red, less saturation. If I want to create, for example, a brightness and contrast and hit again CTRL ALT G, I can still play with it and we will only affect the desired layer. See? And I can change the order and it won't affect the stone. If I want to remove that, all I gotta do is hit CTRL ALT G again. And see, it's applying to everything, and when I press it, it only is applied to the linked one. And you can keep on putting things, for example, and it's all applying to the same linked layer. This way you can work in a non-destructive way, and for example, in the future, if your boss or the client changes, or even your teacher changes anything in your project and you render again, you can just replace it and everything that you've done before will automatically update and you don't have to work at it all again. So the next item is layer modes. This one is very important when you're dealing with shadows, when you want to give a bit more contrast or maybe match the properties of your, for example, your cutout to your render. What I'm gonna do to show it is apply some different levels of shadows right here on these new textures. And while I'm doing this, I'm also gonna talk about the fourth item, which is do not hesitate to create as many layers as you need. It's better to have more and then afterwards you can delete them and or maybe merge them than doing everything in the same layer and then when you wanna undo it, there's no way you can accomplish that. So let's create another layer and hit CTRL ALT G, and every time you hit this shortcut that creates this little arrow that links this layer to the other one, it's basically the same as, for example, hitting CTRL from this new layer and creating a mask. It's the same one, but it's easier and faster. So using a brush, I'm going to apply a very slight shadow right here. I mean, it's pretty dark, but once I hit the exactly layer mode that I want, it won't be that dark. And then you change to soft light. And you can lower the opacity too. And what that does, it gives just a little shadow that also gives contrast. Otherwise, if you just use the opacity, it would just bring the whole part just a bit darker, and that's not what we really want. Let's do for this stone part too. Create a new layer, CTRL ALT G, using the brush. I can even lower the opacity of the brush right here and start putting some shadows right there. Soft light and lower the opacity. And let's create another one. I mean, the shadows are layered. They go from not so dark to the darkest right on the edge. So for that, I like to create multiple layers with multiple shadow strength. You can even lower the opacity. And this is before and after. See? The fifth item from the list is organize your Photoshop file. As I said before, don't be afraid to create as many layers as you want, but let's say after an hour from working in the same file, you get 100 layers and you get lost. So you can start by grouping similars. Let's say those are textures, but I wanna separate stone textures from wood textures. So So I select everything I want and hit CTRL G. Another option is hitting this button down here, and that creates a group. In that group I can rename it for stone textures, for example, and give it probably like a gray color. The wood one I can do the same, hit CTRL G, rename it wood texture, and give it a color, I don't know, yellow. You will think that this is tedious and may consume a lot of time, but you're gonna thank me later when you've got a huge file to handle. Oops, I just saw that I spelled wood incorrectly. There we go. So the item number 6 from the list is brushes. I know there should be an entire video for brushes, and if you want, just ask below and I can do it. However, in this video I'm gonna focus on some basic stuff. I'm gonna show you how to load different brushes so you don't have to use the default ones. I like to use the brush set from Arcanine. You can find it to download online on their website. And what that brush set gives is a variety of options, from vegetation brushes to some round soft brushes. They are quite enough. If you want to choose only one brush preset to use across all of your images, I would suggest using theirs. And when you go in Photoshop, you can hit B and hit the right button to open this tab. You can go in the little gear right here and go to load brushes. I have a couple of brush presets, and you'll just have to select and then load. And what we'll do is add to your main box right here. The best tip that I can give you for brushes is be quick when changing its size or hardness. There's a quick way. You can hold Alt and slide to the left and right to change its diameter. And you can still hold Alt but go up and down to change its hardness. The last item from the list is the final touch. I've talked about it in all the videos that I've done so far. And the thing is, due to the time and deadlines, I don't usually go too far on the 3D model and then rendering, and I usually spend a little bit more time in Photoshop. And what the final touch that I'm talking about gives me is the opportunity to give it a lot more details without spending too much time. So the final touch that I'm talking about is Topaz Labs. It's a paid plugin, but you can get a 30-day free trial in their website. I'm gonna show you how you can use them. First, create a new layer above everything that I've worked so far, and hit CTRL, ALT, SHIFT, E, everything together. And what that does is, in your new created layer, it will copy everything you have and paste it as a merged layer. And then after that, you can go to Filter, Topaz Lab, and this I have the Topaz Clarity. There are many other options in their website. It's gonna load, and I usually use one of those three, Cityscape 1, 2, and 3. You can just, I mean, this image won't show much difference, but when you apply to a fully worked render with lots of details and cutouts, plants, sunlight, everything, it gives a much better result. Let's go in the Cityscape 3, so you can play with the opacity bar in clarity to control how much detail the filter is gonna apply, and also how much color. I'm gonna leave it at 100 of both. Hit OK. And as you can see, there are some differences. It gives a lot of more details, contrast in the whole image. Alright, so that is the end of the list. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and hopefully some of these tricks will help you get a faster and more precise workflow to finish your architecture renders. Don't forget to subscribe, leave it a like, and comment if you have any questions or want to suggest anything for the next videos. I'll be doing more in-depth tutorials to show more specific things to do, so be tuned. Bye.